So sort of a quick disclaimer before we get into this video. This was meant to be uploaded last Saturday. However, due to rescheduling problems and, the fact that United got linked to some different players, it's meant that we've rescheduled this video to today instead, which does mean some things aren't quite as relevant. Like you will hear me talking about João Neves having a big game coming up for the Portugal under-21 side at the European Championships this weekend. That was now actually last weekend. The game has already been played. João Neves played really well in that game, so I still recommend you go watch it back. And if you need a link, DM me on Twitter. The link will be in the description down below for my Twitter. But yeah, so when I'm talking about Portugal and João Neves having this game coming up this weekend, that was actually last weekend. But enjoy the video. Hey guys, welcome back to the AJ Analysis channel and the Scouting for United series, where today we are talking about Benfica and Portugal midfielder João Neves. Now, the reason that we are talking about Neves is because over the past few days, he has been linked with the club, and pretty much everyone has no idea what he is as a footballer. But fear not, João Neves is actually a player that I was already actively scouting and have been this season. Now, I say this season, it's only been the past couple of months, because he has only played 640 minutes of senior football. So, everything we look at in terms of stats and his profile, it is based on quite a small sample size. However, I am currently working on getting access to some of his footage from the youth team, so if he does become more heavily linked with the club, we can revisit him once again. But like I said, fortunately for you guys, I already know a lot about João Neves. So, like I said, Portuguese, about 5'8" tall and currently 18 years old, and actually representing Portugal very well in the European Championships, literally right now, depending on what day this video is uploaded. João Neves is about to face England in the quarterfinals. Now, that game is on Sunday, I believe, on UEFA TV, so I highly recommend that you watch that match to see João Neves in action against some players you're more familiar with from the England under-21 team. So, what will you see when you watch João Neves? What are his strengths? What are his weaknesses? What even is his position to start off with? It would help if we had a football pitch on screen. Here we go. Well, if João Neves was to kind of play for Manchester United or for anyone really, he is very much a central midfielder. He's kind of looking to play in this position here, typically as a left-sided central midfielder in my opinion, although for Portugal he's often been on the right side of central midfield in kind of a diamond at times. But either way, he is very much a central midfielder that is capable of playing on either side of the midfield. Now, in terms of profile, what does he do? What is he good at? He's a very, very technical footballer. Now, I'm not going to go as far as saying press resistant just yet in his career, simply because playing for Benfica, where they're better than most teams in the league, we haven't seen him put under too much pressure in deeper areas. However, he is a very technical player, so he is capable of receiving the ball under pressure. Now, he doesn't necessarily always kind of drop a shoulder and turn when he's under pressure, but he's very good at protecting the ball, and he'll often bring a teammate into the game. And that's kind of how he'll evade pressure. For example, if he was pressed in a situation as he receives the ball, he'll pop it off to someone else. Now, you know, that's not the same as what someone like Frenkie de Jong does, but it's still very, very effective, and it keeps the ball for his side. And that is really where João Neves excels, keeping the ball for his side. He is a very, very good passer. He's kind of your typical modern-day pass-and-move footballer. He'll get the ball here, in two touches he'll pass it to a teammate. He'll then be in this position, he'll get the ball back, within two touches he's passed it to a teammate. He then might pop up over here, two passes he's passed it to a teammate. He is that typical pass and move footballer, which we see coming through a lot of academies now. Kind of in the lower leagues, the National League, this is what you would call an academy midfielder. That is the sort of player he is. And we can see that in his passing FBref report, where literally he is metronomic in the way that he plays. Passes attempted, the 96th percentile, and passes completed, once again, the 96th percentile. This is someone who looks to get on the ball. Now, in terms of passes completed short, the 94th, passes completed medium, the 96th, and passes completed long, the 87th percentile. All round, a very, very good passer. Now, on top of this, he's also a good progressive passer. So this isn't just kind of safe passing for the sake of it. He's also good at moving the ball forward through the lines into pockets of space. And again, his FBref report did actually kind of show that. If we look somewhere, whereabouts is it, towards the top there, progressive passing distance in the 83rd percentile. Now, once again, we have to consider that the sample size is, of course, quite small. But despite that, João Neves has done very, very well in his games in senior football so far. He is very, very tidy on the ball. Now, in terms of how that potentially suits United, it's a very different profile to anything else that they have. Even with Casemiro, Bruno Fernandes, Eriksen, Mason Mount, João Neves is something a little bit different, because he looks to keep the ball a bit more, manage the tempo, slow things down, rather than always looking forward. He's very good at dictating the tempo of the game, and that could be quite nice in this United team. Now, like I've said already, he's also very technical in the way in which he receives the ball, and this is again represented in his FB Ref Report, where he ranks in the 90th percentile for take-ons completed, and the 82nd percentile for successful take-ons. Now, we can see that the percentages aren't necessarily that great, but what we can see is that he's a player which is confident receiving the ball and trying things. Now, I wouldn't describe him as a progressive carrier as such, he's not someone who's going to really drive through the middle, but once in this second phase, he does possess that drop of a shoulder to turn an opponent and move the ball forward. And again, it really just highlights the fact that all round, he's a very technically secure player. He is a proper, you know, if we're talking the 2010 Spanish midfielders, that is the sort of vibe which João Neves really gives me. So before we continue into the video, a quick shout out to today's video sponsor, JerseyFIFA.com, the home of all of the greatest football kits. Whether that be the new latest releases or the old classic ones like this, Jersey FIFA has something for everyone, and now you can check it out yourself using the link in the description down below. And also make sure to use code JerseyFIFA for 10% off when you order. Now on top of this, João Neves also seems to be really good from a defensive point of view, and particularly with his pressing. Any time that his side loses the ball, his first thought is always, can I win the ball back nice and quickly, nice and high up the pitch? This is the first thing on his mind pretty much every single time, and again I do think we have the numbers for it somewhere. Here we go. Tackles in the attacking third, 0.44 per 90, ranking him in the 93rd percentile, but also tackles in the middle third, the 83rd percentile. This is someone who wins the ball back quickly. Once he loses the ball, he pounces forward. That is always his first thought. Can I get the ball back as quickly as possible? And as a result, he covers a lot of ground. This is a terrier-like midfield, constantly covering ground all over the pitch. Like I've said already, sometimes he'll pop up on this side, sometimes through the middle. He's everywhere, basically. He's always trying to get on the ball, always trying to win the ball back, and that is, of course, a positive thing. But importantly, he can defend going the other way if needed as well. And again, in his defensive FB Ref Report, we can see defensive third tackles, the 99th percentile, and just tackles in general. Tackles one, the 99th percentile, and tackles the 98th percentile. This is almost a ball-winning midfielder, and his numbers even in deeper areas are good as well. Dribblers tackled, the 99th percentile, dribblers challenged, the 98th percentile. Again, showing that he puts in a lot of tackles. He's always trying to get across the pitch, but he's also intercepting passes, he's blocking shots. He really does do a little bit of everything, and I would describe him as an all-action midfielder. Now, those are his strengths, but what are his weaknesses? Because all players have them, and especially a player which only has 640 minutes at senior level. Well, one of the weaknesses is still his frame a little bit. He does need to bulk up and learn to use his body a little bit better. On top of that, I would like to see him further developing his press resistance to potentially become a player which really excels in the first phase. Thus far, we haven't particularly seen it in his short career, but I do think that he has the skill set to really develop and take it to the next level. And then finally, on top of that, I would like to see a bit more output in the final third. He has already chipped in with a couple of goals. He got a very important last-minute equaliser for Benfica against Sporting, and he also scored for the Portugal under-21s from the edge of the penalty area on the half volley just the other day. But I think we can see more creativity from him in the final third. That vision for the final pass to kind of thread a ball through, that is something that I would like to see from him. However, still at 18 years old, and like I said, he's played such little football, he looks like technically a very, very sound player. So, how would he fit into this Manchester United team? Well, I think it would be on the left side of this central midfield spot, and I don't think he would be a regular starter at all. I don't see that in the near future in his career. However, when he comes into the team, I think he would be a useful player, because of the fact that he is someone which wants to control the tempo. So let's say United were to build possession in this sort of shape which we've spoken about before. It kind of changes from video to video, but it looks something like this. From this sort of position, his willingness to dictate the tempo could be very useful. Short passing, not always forcing the pass forward, keeping the ball for his side, helping United to gain possession but also territory as they move up the pitch. That would be very, very useful. And he's also very good at moving the ball forward through the line, so he would bring that aspect as well. And then defensively, he does suit that pressing style which Erik ten Hag wants to play. He's a very, very good presser and also a counter-presser, whilst also, as we've seen already, he is happy to put the work in defending going the other way. I really like João Neves as a player. He looks like a really good fit. Now, like I've said already, it is difficult for me to come to any real conclusions in terms of should Manchester United sign him or how good is he going to be in his career. It is very, very difficult to say at this moment in time, simply because, as I've said again, I've got it written here, he has played 640 minutes of senior football. It's very, very difficult to make a judgment of a player in that shorter amount of time. However, from what we've seen so far, he looks like a very good player. He stepped in and has taken Enzo Fernandez's position in that Benfica team, and impressed really well. He came into the team as they needed to crunch and win the title. They turned to João Neves and he performed. He performed very, very well. At 17 years old, he was starting in a game against Sporting, which is a very, very big game in Portugal, in which Benfica was looking to secure the league title. And as I've said already, he scored a last minute equaliser and overall, in my opinion, impressed with his performance. He's also been impressive for the Portuguese under 21 side, and in general, I think there is a very good player in there. But we are just going to have to wait and see how he develops. Now, like I said earlier on in the video, if he does become more heavily linked with a move to United, and we do actually see some traction in that department, then I will make an effort to watch back a load of his youth games to kind of see more of him as a player, basically. It's not the best level to test him against, but it gets us to see a bit more about his profile as a footballer. But for now, this is what there is to talk about. He's very technical, he's very good on the ball, happy to receive. He can absorb pressure and lay the ball off to a teammate, very, very good at that. In terms of short range, medium range and long range passing, he's got a little bit of everything in his locker. And in general, he passes the ball a lot. A player which dictates the tempo and is metronomic on the ball, whilst also possessing the ability to progress the ball through the lines. In terms of creativity in the final third, he isn't there just yet. But if his side does lose the ball, he is the first player to trigger the counter press and look to win possession high up the pitch, whilst also possessing the defensive capabilities. As a base player, he looks very, very nice, but for now, we are just going to have to wait and see. So that's all I have to say for today's video. But let me know what you think in the comments down below. Have you been watching him for the Portuguese under 21 side? Did you watch him last season for Benfica? And if so, what did you think of him? And also, again, I do really recommend that you go and watch the Portugal versus England under 21 quarterfinal, because I think it will be a good game. I also recommend that you subscribe to the channel with notifications on. But apart from that, thank you guys for watching. I hope you have enjoyed it. And as always, I'll see you in the next one.